What's going on, Dodgers Nation? Doug McCain here. For all the latest MLB trade rumors, follow me on Twitter at DMAC_LA. For all latest Dodgers breaking news and rumors, subscribe to the Dodgers Nation YouTube channel. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that notification bell. And if you want to see us post even more Dodgers content, smash that like button. And as always, I want your takes down below in the comments section. Today's Dodgers Nation question of the day. Do you think the Dodgers should trade for Craig Kimbrel or Max Scherzer? And two, do you think they ultimately will end up with either Craig Kimbrel or Max Scherzer? Call your shot down below in the comments section. I want to know what you guys have to say. Should they go all in on elite reliever and an elite starter? Give me all your takes. And for all this Dodgers news, head over to DodgersNation.com. So we're inching closer and closer to the MLB trade deadline, which is this Friday, July 30th, and the rumors are heating up. The rumors are hotter than a fire hydrant chasing a dog at this point, and we've got some good ones to get into today. The first one comes from friend of Dodgers Nation, ESPN MLB insider Buster Only, who said yesterday on the Baseball Tonight podcast that he predicts that elite closer Craig Kimbrel will ultimately be traded to the Los Angeles Dodgers. He said, "I'm going to say he winds up with the Dodgers based on some stuff I heard over the weekend." Now, yes, it's just speculation. Yes, it's just his guess, but let's throw this on the Dodgers rumor meter. Craig Kimbrel to the Dodgers. To me, at this point, I'm going to give this a two Dodger dogs. The two Dodger dogs, people are talking, guys like Buster Only, people in the industry, everyone always thinks that the Dodgers are going to get everyone, but I don't think it's serious smoke at this point, because I truly believe that right now, Andrew Friedman and the Dodgers, they're focusing their efforts on trying to land a starting pitcher. Now, Craig Kimbrel would be nice. He would go a long way to helping this Dodger bullpen. But if you look at it, there's a lot of bodies in that pen, especially when guys continue to get healthy. You've got Blake Treinen, Joe Kelly, Jimmy Nelson, Bruzdar Graterol, Kenley Jansen, the much maligned Kenley Jansen, Victor Gonzalez, Corey Knebel. He started a game for AAA OKC yesterday through 15 pitches, so he's on the mend. And then you've got Tony Gonsolin, could potentially go into that Dodgers bullpen when they add another starter at the deadline. Same with David Price. Then you've got Ryan Pepiot, who could possibly come up, and then Josiah Gray. Will they use him? So that bullpen is a little crowded if they were to add a Craig Kimbrel, but if you look at the numbers, the bullpen has a 3.72 ERA this year. That's good for ninth in Major League Baseball. 1.28 whip. That's also good for ninth. A 2.23 opponent's batting average. Good for sixth. A 25.1 K percentage. That's good for 11th. But if you look at the 23 blown saves, that's more than any team in Major League Baseball. They're 31 for 54 in save opportunities this year. And yes, Kenley Jansen was having a really nice bounce back year up until the All-Star break. He had a 2.61 ERA in 10 and thirds innings in April, had a 1.5 ERA in 12 innings pitched in May. In June, he had a 0 ERA in 10 and thirds innings pitched. But if you look at July, a 10.8 ERA in 6 and two-thirds innings pitched. And up until the All-Star break, he had only blown two saves on the season. Following it, already three saves in four appearances. He blew the save against the Rockies, two against the Giants. Had a nice bounce back save against the Rockies, which was good to see. But even though Kenley's had his good moments this year, he hasn't inspired enough confidence over the last few seasons to justify giving him that closer's role when it matters most in October. Look no further than last season when the Dodgers were going with Julio Urias and Blake Treinen in big spots. So they could add Craig Kimbrel. He's been outstanding. He's been elite. We went into his numbers last time. He is fantastic. He's also been great post the MLB crackdown on sticky stuff. He's also under team control for another season potentially. He has that club option, and if you're the Dodgers, you know you want Bruzdar Graterol to be that lockdown closer at some point, but is he ready? I don't think he is at this point. And then next year, Kenley Jansen's off the book. So is Joe Kelly. He can come in and be that closer for 1 year and kind of transition that closer's role as the Dodgers look for their next guy. Hopefully they continue to develop Bruzdar Graterol and he molds himself into that spot. But when it comes to this season in particular, is he a must get? Do the Dodgers need to get an elite closer to win it all this year? I think the answer is no. And if you look at the prospect capital it would require to land Craig Kimbrel, I think it'd be a little too enormous for the Dodgers liking. I think if they're going to cash in on some of these elite top prospects, they would want to do it for an elite position player, an elite pitcher, not an elite closer. So for me, I would like to see Craig Kimbrel on the Dodgers, and I would like to see him not join the San Diego Padres, but I would also be very reluctant to include guys like Keibert Ruiz or Josiah Gray, Michael Bush, Bobby Miller, Ryan Pepiot, those types. Now, would you consider a package surrounding guys like Landon Knack or Beater, guys like that? Maybe you would. Maybe include a Cody Hosey type to be the centerpiece of the deal, but there's going to be a lot of teams out there, a lot of suitors that are in need of an elite relief pitcher. I think Craig Kimbrel will end up with another team. And another thing you want to consider, too, is that this organization has been very loyal to Kenley Jansen. He signed to that five-year, $80 million contract. He's the franchise's all-time leader in saves with 334. And I think they realized if they were going to trade for Craig Kimbrel, it might really damage his confidence, and they want to get something out of Kenley Jansen. And I think Kenley would be more likely to take a closer-by-committee role with the guys currently on the team versus bringing in a Craig Kimbrel, and he's trying to compete with them. And I just think that the Dodgers just might not do that. Just my personal feeling. I hope that we add Craig Kimbrel, and I hope that we do it with the right package. But with Blake Treinen and when Corey Knebel gets healthy, they're going to have some guys that can close other than Kenley Jansen. Look at Joe Kelly recently. He's been pitching very well. So the Dodgers definitely have some internal options they can go to if they don't trade for a lockdown closer. Now, the next rumor is involving Max Scherzer. He is the big fish during this trade deadline. And early this morning, Mark Feinsand tweeted, "It remains to be seen if Max Scherzer will be traded, but his source said that the pitcher strongly prefers the West Coast to waive his no-trade clause. Given the state of the NL West, he could be the difference maker in that race if landed with the Dodgers, Giants, or Padres." So that changes a lot of things, because you heard a lot of people out there talking about Max Scherzer potentially going to the Houston Astros. And is this Max Scherzer saying, "I don't want to go to Houston. I don't want to join the organization that we beat in the 2019 World Series," and two, the organization that is known for the 2017 sign-stealing scandal? And also, he wants to come to the West Coast. He wants to join either the Giants, Padres, or Dodgers. The next question I have is, can we get some information on the extension talks? Is he going to have to go to a team that's willing to extend him? Because if the Padres are, the Giants are, they're going to have a big advantage over the Dodgers. Now, if all three teams are, does it become a negotiating tactic? It's going to be really complicated from that standpoint. But I do think that it is a promising development if you're the Dodgers and wanting to get Max Scherzer. And then Ken Rosenthal, he tweeted out, "Teams pursuing Scherzer believe Nats want to act within the next 48 hours to create time to work through his no trade. Chances of Scherzer making his start Thursday seem remote. Scratch from last start due to right tricep discomfort. Teams might ask, how do we know he is healthy?" I think that really, look, they said, you saw Dave Martinez say it was a clean MRI. He says that he's going to be okay. It's nothing serious. He has been rocked a little bit in the month of July. Two rough starts against the San Diego Padres. But look, Scherzer's been shoving all season long. A 2.83 ERA, good for 12th in the league. A 3.37 xFIP, good for 7th. He's second in Sierra at 2.91. First in K percentage at 35.1%. A 1.82 batting average against. 14th in WAR at 2.5. So he's had an outstanding season, and today he just turned 37 years old. Maybe they give him a little birthday present and send him away today to either the Giants, Dodgers, or Padres. We'll see about that. I think when it comes to Max Scherzer, it is going to come down to that extension and the prospect haul they want in return. I don't think the Dodgers will include Keibert Ruiz, but his stock is never going to be this high. They just moved him up to number 16 on Baseball America's top prospect list. You saw he was the AAA player of the week. The big Keibert was raking last week. He hit 444 with 4 home runs. He's just going off in AAA. So I don't think they're going to move him during the season. If they were going to actually cash in on him, I think it'd be with a more calculated trade in the offseason. I don't think that they would rush to trade him during a season where they didn't expect to trade for a big starter. Because look, the Dodgers thought they had made their power move in the offseason when it came to adding a starting pitcher with Trevor Bauer. So this was very unexpected, so I don't see them dealing Ruiz in this deal. And then just now, John Heyman, he tweeted out, "Interest is predictably immense in Max Scherzer, who is suddenly the most impactful guy on the market and very likely to be traded. There are said to be about 14 teams that have called, including some barely in the race." So that tells me that ones that are not in the race, maybe they are considering offering him an extension, and then he's kind of having his pick of the litter because he has those 10 to 5 rights, 10 years of service time. time, 5 years with the same team. He can veto any trade. So it'll get complicated. I think the Dodgers, to get him, would have to overpay, then possibly extend him. I think they should look at their other options. Guys like Barrios, who still has one more year of team control. Guys like Luis Castillo, maybe a Danny Duffy, maybe a Pablo Lopez, who my man Brooke Smith was talking about last night on the Blue Heaven podcast. So there's some other guys out there that could be available. Max Scherzer, that's the biggest name. That's the guy you want to see in Dodger Blue. I would love to see Mad Max in LA. There's no question about it. But let me know down below in the comment section. Do you think the Dodgers will ultimately end up with Max Scherzer? And should they trade Keibert Ruiz for Max Scherzer? Would you be willing to include him in a deal? And also, do you think LA lands Craig Kimbrough? I want all your takes down below in the comment section. My name is Doug McCain. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at DMAC_LA. For all things Dodger baseball, subscribe to the Dodgers Nation YouTube channel. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that notification bell. And if you want to see us post even more Dodgers content, smash that like button. For all latest Dodgers Nation merch, head over to GearUp.LA. Some of the best Dodgers t-shirt designs in the game. You're going to find it right over there at www.GearUp.LA. For the latest Dodgers news, head over to DodgersNation.com. And until next time, think blue, bleed blue, and I'm out.